subscribe to my channel, and also press this bell icon.
Oran, we need to ask you for a favor.
I stopped accepting commissions a long time ago. Sorry, you two, but you'll just have to ask another adventurer.
Oh, it's not that kind of favor. It's just a teeny tiny thing.
Wow. Just wow. Do I look like the kind of girl who wears perfume to you? I think you're underestimating the kind of person I am.
Well, Paimon thinks you smell amazing. So come on, Lon. What's your secret if not perfume?
Now that you mention it, yes, there is something. What is that scent? Oh, it must be from the Qingxing flowers I picked on the way back. I forgot I still had them with me.
Aha! The truth is out. Lon's got a soft spot for wildflowers.
No, they were for medicinal use only. Anyway, this is a pointless conversation. If you want to know about perfume, try talking to Qi Ming.
The fortune teller, right? Paimon remembers she smells pretty good. Thanks, Lon. See you around.
I'm Bung's Ironmonger. Here to serve.
Hello. How may I help?
We've come to ask you a question.
Perfume? I rarely think to use it. Let me get myself. That said, some of the cosmetics I use are scented. Perhaps that's the cause of this confusion. Since I usually set up my stall by the docks, I avoid perfume like the plague, because Celestia forbid those lusty sailors catch a whiff and come hunting for the source.
That's the worst thing Paimon's heard all day!
While we're on the subject, have you never heard anyone mention Ying'er's homemade perfume?
Ying'er? Oh, as in scent of spring Ying'er?
Yes, that's her. Many a rich family's daughter has gotten her to make perfume for them. Apparently, her homemade product is better than anything you'll find on the market.
Great! This is just the intel we need! Finally, we're getting somewhere!
Well, hello. You found me at last. I've been waiting for you.
What? How did you know we were coming?
Oh, I heard a rumor about a couple who were snooping around town looking for a sweet-smelling lady. Actually, I was starting to worry you wouldn't find me. This is the ultimate test of my appeal, after all.
Snooping around? Why are you making it out like we're bad people?
What can I say? People love to talk. Maybe you ought to be more discreet in the future if you don't want word to get around. Relax. I know why you're here. You want to get your hand on my homemade perfume, don't you? What kind would you like? 3-in-1 go, my goodness. You have extreme tastes for someone your age. Maybe the rumors I heard were true after all. You're on the prowl and need some sweet-smelling ammunition. Is that it? Is that the best you could come up with? Even if you were genuinely offering perfume to a deity, that doesn't explain why you'd need 3 kinds. Sorry, your story just doesn't hold water.
Zhang Li was right. People don't remember this tradition anymore.
As one of my favorite poems goes, O cherry tree, begrudge not thy blossoms as they are deflowered in the spring, for come winter, even thy sturdiest wood shall wither.
That went over Paimon's head a little.
In short, I'm happy to help. Traveler, you can be my assistant. But you'd better make sure I'm the only person on your mind while you're hanging around with me. So, where is a good place for making sweet, sweet perfume? Where's that, Mondstadt? We're only making some perfume. There's no need to go to such ridiculous lengths. Somewhere closer to home will do. Let's go for the kitchen at Wan Min Restaurant. I've had a word with Chef Mao. We can start work now. Are you ready to please me?
What did you say?
I meant make me proud, as my assistant, obviously. While I'm setting up, you can go and fetch some water. This water will do nicely. Now, I need you to extract the silk flower essence using a crafting bench. Perfume making uses an altogether different technique from alchemy. Here, let me teach you. Very carefully, take hold of the mortar and pestle. Gently dose it. You need to keep your wrist firm so your hand doesn't slip. Now use your strong hand to stir it with a persistent rhythm. Keep going until the juices start to come out. Ooh, you're a natural, like a fish to water. Now take these and try it out on your own using a nearby crafting bench. Don't forget to do all three. They look visually identical during the essence extraction process, but I will put them into separate containers when the perfume is ready.
Try something new at the Wan Min Restaurant.
Wow! This is some exquisite silk flower essence. On to the next stage, the most important one of all. The essence is placed into water and simmered over a low heat until most of the water has boiled off. You must take care to control the heat during this process. If the temperature goes too high, it will affect the scent. So please, focus on controlling the heat. This is the final step. Don't waste a drop of that essence now. We want all of it in there. All three perfumes are ready. And you, my friend, were a wonderful assistant. A testament to the lengths you will go to for romance. It's so rare to see nowadays. Anyway, shall I give you a brief overview of each scent? It might just help you match the right scent to the right occasion.
Paima wants to hear this!
This first one is sweet as candy, straight out of a fairy tale. Younger women will love it. The second one is for those with more refined tastes, the first choice for daughters of high society. Finally, the third one has a soft but lingering scent, like a mist that captures the last light of dusk. Mature women adore this one. All clear? Don't get them mixed up now. You'll ruin the mood. Good. Be sure to come visit if you ever need help with anything, okay? I'll leave you with some parting words. One who tries to sail three boats simultaneously should be careful not to go overboard.
Try something new at the One Man Restaurant.
Over to the Statue of the Seven. Mr. We've brought the perfumes, Mr. Zhengli. Did we take too long? You were just staring up at the statue.
Oh, you're back. Don't worry, I haven't waited long. Compared to the watch that Rex Lapis's statues have kept over Liyue, this was but a brief moment.
Well, how can a person compete with a statue?
That is true. Well, have you brought the perfumes?
Three sets, and not one less!
Thank you both. Let us offer them up.
This is the first kind of perfume. Miss Yinger said that it's sweet as a dream, and it's liked by younger ladies. This is the second kind. It's got an elegant smell, and the daughters of high society love it. The third kind has a gentle but lingering fragrance. Something like the dusk mist, and it's a favorite of mature ladies. Oh, what was that? That's the one older ladies like, right? Does that mean that Rex Lapis is actually an older lady?
Perhaps. Perhaps. Rex Lapis has taken on countless forms. Perhaps that really was one of them.
What a shame. We only got to see the giant dragon form, and... Let's hope the Chi-Sing can catch the real killer.
We can leave that to the authorities. Let us focus on the fond farewell for Rex Lapis.
So, we've finished another step in our preparations. What's next?
Next, I would like the two of you to help me borrow the cleansing bell.
Cleansing bell?
At present, a friend of mine named Madame Ping is the guardian of the cleansing bell. She lives near Yujing Terrace. If you ask her, she will know what to do.
Sure, but aren't you going to come with us?
Ah, I have certain reasons why I cannot be there in person. Please, do this for me.
Man, why has he gotta be so secretive this time?
All things must change. Youngster, are you here to admire the flowers? But it's a shame. These glazed lilies have almost all wilted.
What happened to them?
Back in my day, people said that glazed lilies can read human hearts. If they heard beautiful sounds like laughter and singing, they would also bloom joyfully. But if they heard too much wild gossip or slander, they would quickly wither away.
So that means these flowers feel what's happening in Liyue?
Yes. The rumors of Rex Lapis's death are no small matter. They are everywhere. Some say it was a Fatui plot. Others say that the Chi-Sing made it all up, And still others think that that which lies in the deep is breaking free. This harbor is like a mountain of dry tinder. One spark, and the fire will consume us all. Well, I shall say no more. This old woman's grown too old and naggy. Did you have something to say, youngster? Ah, that old trinket. I remember it being here with me, but I've grown old. I can't quite recall where it is exactly. An old friend of mine used to wear it on his person, back when I was young. He saw me gazing at it often and gave it to me. But he told me then that if someone should come to borrow that bell, I should not be loath to part with it. It has been many years, and who knows how many times someone has come to borrow this bell. Still, though, I can't recall when it started. It's been a long time since anyone has come to borrow it. Oh, these old bones are so slow to look for things. I doubt you can wait that long.
That's right, Granny. We'll follow you back home and search for it ourselves. And, we can help with chores if you have any, too.
All right, children. There is no need to worry. I didn't place the bell very far away.
Do you live near here, Granny? Whoa, but this is Eugene Terrace. It's gotta be expensive.
Oh, an old lady like me can't afford to buy a place in this city. See this ceramic teapot? My entire household is in here.
How does that work?
Oh, youngsters. I simply mean that the bell is somewhere inside this teapot, and you are quite welcome to borrow it. If you can find it.
This granny's so weird. What does she mean her whole household is in here? Is she playing with...
Youngsters, this is where this old woman keeps all her things. Quickly now, go fetch that bell.
Whoa, that sounds like Granny's voice. So, this is her teapot? What's going on?
Oh dear, so many cobwebs. It seems I really haven't cleaned it in a long while. Sorry to trouble you, children. Please help an old lady clean up.
So is flame!
teapot and the cleansing bell? Do you think this old granny could also be an adeptus? Paimon's more and more convinced that she's an adeptus. But don't they all live in Jillian Karst? Why would she stay in the city?
Youngsters are so quick on their feet. Oh, now, let me... All right, that'll do. Come on out now, children. Oh, in and out in no time. You youngsters really are quick. An adeptus. Oh, I haven't heard anyone say those words in earnest for a long time. As to whether I am one or not, child, surely you already understand.
Ugh. Paimon kinda knows what you mean, but is also kinda confused. Are you really giving us the bell just like that, Granny? Don't you think it's weird? Something's just happened to Rex Lapis, and then we come running up asking for it?
Oh, don't be silly. Liyue Harbor has been through a great deal in its history. In that time, it has seen the departure of countless Adepti. But no matter what, we have always performed the rite of parting first before any other matters. To cry, catch the murderer at the top of one's lungs, but ignore the rite of parting. That, to me, is what is wrong-headed. Now that you have come to borrow the bell, I guess that perhaps an old friend of mine has finally decided to take matters into their own hands. So, why would I be unwilling to lend you the bell? Oh? Well, if it came to that, they would find a certain old lady knocking at their door. We haven't met in a while anyway. It would be nice to share a drink and chat. Well, you must have things to do. Since you have the bell, you should return. Oh, and do tell the person who sent you that if they have time, they can come over for tea. I don't have much to offer, but you can always count on an old lady for a pot of tea.
We will!